going to pull out some of the elements of this story structure. Let's go over basic story architecture first. So when you first start writing and filmmaking, you have a linear perspective in that sense. Pretty soon you realize that both the beginning and the ending are the same, which is why we demonstrate story structure via a loop. We identify the classic beginning and ending, the state of perfection, which is loss, becomes state of imperfection, the loss phase, the limitations phase, and the process of returning to it is undergone. You can start there, or somewhere in between. If you do that, the events there tend to be referenced at later stages, as in this story. Most stories end with some form of state of perfection, as in this one. If you don't want to do that, if you want to end with imperfection or some combination, that's almost irrelevant. The process is almost always the same. So you're always going to have transformation, change, metamorphosis, transmogrification, the various arcs, etc. You're always going to have a psychological journey, you're always going to have a physical journey, and you're always moving through new worlds, which really are physical manifestations of new psychological states and new versions of the self. Working your way around the cycle involves jumping through lots of hoops. Each hoop has its own set of sub-stages, which in essence are functions which may be performed, messages which may be communicated, they tell you what tangibles or intangibles you're going in there to acquire, how to construct those sequences. So for example, if that's the ordinary world, we know it's a state of protection, repression, fear of exit, etc. So those sub-stages show you how to construct those sequences. When you are here, you're not able to return, so you have to go forward, grow, learn, mature, evolve, change, let go of the older limitations, representations of your older self, come all the way around until you are ready to return. So that's basic story architecture. It's the fundamental framework that all successful stories are based around, and I go over that in great detail in the 2100 stage show, Journey, Transformation, Movement Through New Worlds and States, which you can purchase off the website. So let's get rid of that, and let's draw another loop, so we know now there's much more behind that than a simple circle would suggest. So in her, we've got, in essence, the state of perfection has been lost. We're coming into our imperfect state, the loss phase. And in essence, what we're doing is we're referencing damage. So Theodore is getting a divorce. He can't let go of his ex-wife. He's attached. And when Amy calls, she says she wants the old happy Theodore back, not this sad, morose person that he's become. So all referencing the damage. Also, Theodore's working in this job where he's writing love letters. So that's all about people who, again, can't let go of their attachments. And he's also becoming attached to them, as is referenced later. He's known them all for a long time. So he leaves work, and in essence, we go into our ordinary world. So he's going home, and that's where we have the flashbacks of him and his wife when he was happy, when the state of perfection existed. That is no longer. He's also alone. He's playing video games, and that character in the video game is also a type of attachment. So then he exits that, and that's when he's exposed to the advert for the OS, and then he goes and buys the OS, and that's where we meet Samantha. So in essence, we have three main characters. We've got Theodore, we've got Amy, and we've got Samantha, and they're all going to change. Moving on, we've got our supernatural aid functions. So Amy forms a function, says, come to my apartment. In other words, pulling him out of his ordinary world, and we've also got Samantha encouraging him, Theodore, to go on a date, in other words, to let go. All of that is resisted, so we've got refusals there. Even in the ordinary world, when Theodore phones a sex chat line, the first caller just wants to chat, which in essence is an encouragement to move forward and let go of your existing attachments, and he refuses that. So refusals all the way through. There are various stages where you have your calls forward, your pushes forward, and your refusals. So first threshold in essence is going into Amy's apartment, and we see her begin to pull away from her boyfriend, again an attachment representing who she was. We've got Theodore resisting pulling away, so he doesn't really want to sign the divorce papers, not keen at all, and he goes on the date, and his date wants to commit, but he hesitates, doesn't want to do that, so all part and parcel of refusing to change. And then the first threshold separation really is when he starts talking to Samantha about it and goes on a walk with her. In essence, that's the beginning of that relationship and beginning pulling away. Moving forward, we've got our innermost fears made explicit, the need for deeper change. So we've got Samantha wants to know what it feels like to be alive, and we've got Theodore wants to just be able to feel again and then have sex, and that's the physical separation, and that's the beginning of the deeper change. So we've got a benchmark here. So this is Theodore not wanting to commit, but then saying, let's go on an adventure. So he and Samantha go on an adventure, and in essence that takes them to our road of trials. And coming out of that, you can see the change in the reversal. So we've got Theodore beginning to tell everybody that he's in a relationship, even though that relationship is with an OS. So all the way around to seizing the tangible sword. So here he's not keen on signing those divorce papers at all. Here he's very keen on it. In other words, he's ready to, or he's letting go. Moving into our underworld stages, the beginning of the detachment of new supernatural aids in the new world. And so we've got Samantha introducing this third person into their relationship, the surrogate. We've got the argument on the street, etc., all representative of detachment, all the way around until we have our atonement, our apotheosis, and our boon. So physical apotheosis, we're leaving the older world behind, we're going on vacation. We've got psychological apotheosis. You can see that from the point of view of Samantha. She's no longer dissatisfied at not having a human body. She appreciates the value. She appreciates that she can grow so much more in her existing form. We've got a boon in terms of the book is being published, and we've got Theodore ready. Here he's alone. Here he's on a couple, and he's going out with another couple. They're going to a picnic, and he's actually where here he was sad. Now he's happy. Moving on, the continued detachment, so we're on vacation, and we realize that Samantha is hanging out more and more with the other OSs. They've created this artificial intelligence, which is the product of that hyper-intelligent human being. All the way around, we're detaching, so this is realizing that Samantha is speaking simultaneously to 8,000 plus people and in love with 600 others, all the way around until we've got our departure function where she and all the other OSs are leaving. So in essence, the supernatural aids depart. All the way around, in essence, we return. So we've got Theodore waking up. He's smiling, so he's happy, so no longer is he morose. He phones Catherine and in essence apologizes and is able to let go. He's happy, as I said, and he goes upstairs, he knocks on Amy's door, and they both leave. So they're leaving their ordinary world, or the world that represented who they were. They're going to the rooftops, they've got liberty symbolism there, and in essence they sit as though they were a couple. So we've got sad to happy, we've got alone to belonging, all the classic reversals that you get as a result of the process. So that's a very basic breakdown of that story. If you want a detailed breakdown of that story, you can order it off the website. But once again, showing you that all of these stories follow this process of journey and transformation and movement through new worlds and states, which, as I said, I go over in great detail in the 2100 stage of journey, transformation, movement through new worlds and states, which you can purchase off the website.